Hello friends, welcome again to the session on quadratic equations. Now, in the previous session, we understood what is meant by quadratic equations, right? Why the word quadratic is used. We learned that in Latin, the word quad is coming from the word quadratus, which means square, and hence quadratic equations. And we also understood that a general form of quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equals 0. This is what we learned, right? This is a quadratic equation, and where a is not equal to 0 and a, b, c are real numbers. That is what we learned. Now, in this session, we are going to understand what is meant by solutions of a quadratic equation. What is meant by solution of a quadratic equation? So solution is nothing but, you can say, these are also called roots of quadratic equation. Okay, what are roots of quadratic equation? So those values of variable, those values of variable which when plugged in the equation, right, the equation is satisfied. That is what is called the solution of a quadratic equation. What is meant by plugging in the values and the equation getting satisfied? So let us take an example and understand it. So let us say we have a quadratic equation, x square minus 3x plus 2 equals 0, right? Where here, if you see, a is equal to 1, clearly b is equal to minus 3 and c is 2. Now let us try this value. So what I'm saying is, let us say putting x is equal to 1 in the equation. So if you do that, what will you get? So x equals to 1 means 1 square minus 3 times 1 plus 2, which is actually equal to 0. That means we can say that x equals to 1 is a solution slash root, whichever word you can use, either of them, sorry, root to the equation, given equation. Okay, similarly, let us say x is equal to 2. You put x equals to 2 in the same equation, you will get 2 square minus 3 times 2 plus 2, which is again equal to 4 minus 6 plus 2, which is equal to 0. So this is also reduced to 0. So hence we say again, x equals to 2 is a solution or root. Correct. Now let us take another value. Let us say x equals to 0. Put x equals to 0. What will happen? It will be 0 square minus 3 times 0 plus 2, which is clearly not equal to 0. So hence we say x equals to 0 is not a solution or root of x square minus 3x plus 2 equals 0. So if you see, you try any other number but for x equals to 1 and 2, you will see that it is not getting reduced to 0. So all those values are definitely not roots to the or the solution of the given equation. So please understand, a quadratic equation can have at maximum how many roots? Only 2 roots. Quadratic equation cannot have more than 2 roots. Yes, it can have a quadratic equation. So hence I can write a quadratic equation, a quadratic equation can have either zero roots, that is no roots, or only one root, or at max two roots. It cannot have more than two roots at any cost, right? And why is this? We can understand this by, you know, when you see when you see through this particular problem from an angle of polynomial. So hence, what was a quadratic equation? If you see, a quadratic equation was nothing but px equals to 0, where px is a quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c, right? And this was equated to 0. So at what value of x this entire thing is reduced to 0 can be traced from the curve of x and px, right? So let us say if you plot x here and this is px here, which is equal to y, in, you know, you have studied this. So hence, if you draw the curve, so it will be something like that, right? So quadratic curves are like that. So if you see, there are two points here and here, which is making, or which where the value of px is 0, right? So there are two values of x, one is here, which is at which the value of px is getting reduced to 0, isn't it? So hence these two values of x are called solution to the quadratic equation px equals to 0. Now any quadratic curve, you would have known that any quadratic curve can have three positions, one like that, so it is not intersecting the x-axis at all, or it just touches the x-axis, or it touches the x-axis twice, correct? So this is the case where there is no solution. So it is not intersecting x-axis, so there is no value of x. If you see, there is no value of x anywhere in this line. There is no value where px is reduced to 0, right? There is no value of x where px is 0. Why? Because if px was 0, then it would definitely touch the x-axis. So in this case, there is one root or one solution. Why? Because it is touching exactly at one point. So only one value of x exists, and this value of x is this, which is, you know, making px 0. And here there are two values of x, one here, another one here, where px is becoming 0. So there are two roots here. Okay, so hence, and if you see, a quadratic curve, you know, a polynomial has only one change in direction, that is, so it either, you know, it has only one change in direction across the number line. What does it mean? So let us say if the quadratic curve is like that, it is decreasing here, and then it will hit its minimum value, and then it will change the direction like that, right? So hence it changes direction only once. So hence there's a possibility that it cuts the x-axis at max two locations, right? Or it might not cut at all. For example, here it is not cutting at all, right? So what is this? This is a graph of px, where px is a quadratic polynomial. So here it is not cutting at all. In another case, it could just touch once, and in another case, it could just cut it at two locations, right? So there are only, so at max it can cut at two locations, and hence we say there are only two possible values or solutions for a quadratic equation, correct? So this is what is meant by solution to a quadratic equation. Let's take a few examples and see whether what is meant by, let's say, solution to a quadratic equation. So let us say we have an equation. Now we are dealing with examples. Let's say example one, we have x square minus 7x plus, let's say, 6 equals to 0. Okay, so if you put x equals to 1 again, so what will you see? You'll see 1 minus 7 into 1 plus 6 is again 0. So x equals to 1 is clearly a solution, right? And what about x equals to 6? If I put x equals to 6 again, you'll get 6 square minus 7 times 6 plus 6, which is again equal to 0. So hence the two roots are x equals to 1 and x equals to 6. How I am finding the roots is a different discussion altogether. But what is meant by root, you now understand. Let us take another example. So let us say I am saying x square minus 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. Okay, so if you see, let us check x equals to 0. So what is x equals to 0? So if you put x equals to 0, it will become 0 minus 5 into 0 plus 4, which is not equal to 0. So hence, x equals to 0 is not the solution. Solution of what? Solution of x square minus 5x plus 4 equals to 0. Right? That means you can think like this, that if you have a polynomial px which is equal to x square minus 5x plus 4, this particular value will not be 0 at x equals to 0. Okay, so hence clearly the curve will not be 0 at x equals to, so this is x equals to 0, so hence at this point the curve will be somewhere here. Okay, so hence it is something like that. Yeah, so if you see x equals to 0, if I put x equals to 0, the value is not 0, px value is not 0, not 0, correct? So, but if we put x equals to 1, again, if you see x equals to 1, what will happen? It will become 1 square minus 5 times 1 plus 4, this is 0, fantastic. So that means this is x equals to 1. At this point, px, if you see px is coming out to be 0 at this point. Right, and similarly, if you check, this point is x equals to 4. At x equals to 4 as well, px is 0. Right, px is coming out to be 0 at x equals to 4 and x equals to 1. Okay, so this is what is meant by solution to a quadratic equation. Now, in the next few sessions, we'll learn what is meant by, how to find out the solution of a given quadratic equation.